Bonjour tout le monde. Hello everyone. Thank you, Minister Baines. It's great to be here with you, as well as Minister Anand and Jerry Dias, the President of Unifor at the Ford Connectivity and Innovation Center. As you can see, we're joined virtually by Premier Ford in Oakville. Doug, it's always good to see you, along with our Member of Parliament for Oakville North Burlington, Pam Damoff, and Ontario Minister Fedeli. We also have the Member of the Provincial Parliament for Oakville, Stephen Crawford, and the President, CEO of Ford Canada, Dean Stoneley. Thank you so much for all your leadership in this, Dean, as well. For too many Canadians, this pandemic has meant worrying about their job or being laid off. Everyone deserves a good job they can rely on. That's why 2 weeks ago, in the speech from the throne, our government outlined a plan to create and protect thousands of good middle-class jobs and build a stronger, more resilient economy by investing in the future. Just last week, we announced a $10 billion infrastructure plan that will create tens of thousands of positions right across the country. And today, we're taking another step forward. The Government of Canada, in partnership with the Government of Ontario and Ford Canada, is investing $1.8 billion to transition Ford's Oakville assembly plant into making zero-emission electric vehicles. The federal government will contribute $295 million towards this project, and the Government of Ontario will do the same. Today's announcement secures over 5,000 good middle-class jobs and is a major vote of confidence in our auto sector. For people in Oakville, Windsor Essex, and Ford's entire production line, I know this is big news. This is just one of the first steps to build a next-generation auto industry. And we have the resources to do that. From aluminum from Quebec to nickel from Ontario, this investment will make a huge impact throughout the supply chain, including the many, many auto parts suppliers throughout the regions. And it positions our workers for success while keeping us competitive as we grow the economy. The market for electric vehicles will grow in the future, and Canada has the talent to be a global leader in making batteries for electric vehicles, electrification, and clean technology. That means we need to secure good jobs now, which will open up more opportunities for our auto sector to thrive into the future. At the same time, by investing in technology that protects the environment, we're also taking action on our plan to get to net zero carbon emissions by 2050. For our auto sector, for our environment, this is a win-win. I want to thank Premier Ford for his continued partnership and acknowledge Jerry Dias and Minister Baines for their incredibly hard work. This is just another example of the important progress we can make when we all work together. Le gouvernement du Canada, en partenariat avec le gouvernement de l'Ontario et la compagnie Ford du Canada, va investir 1,8 milliard de dollars dans l'usine de montage de Ford à Oakville pour lui permettre de passer à la fabrication de véhicules électriques zéro émission. Le gouvernement fédéral et le gouvernement de l'Ontario investiront chacun 295 millions de dollars dans ce projet. Cet investissement permettra de maintenir plus de 5 000 bons emplois pour la classe moyenne. C'est une excellente nouvelle pour les travailleurs et pour les gens d'Oakville et de Windsor-Essex. Mais cette annonce n'est qu'une première étape afin de bâtir la prochaine génération du secteur automobile. Et le Canada détient les ressources nécessaires. Que ce soit l'aluminium qui vient des travailleurs du Québec ou le nickel du nord de l'Ontario, cet investissement aura aussi un impact positif sur la chaîne d'approvisionnement, y compris les beaucoup de petits producteurs de pièces et d'ensembles pour l'industrie automobile. Nous voulons continuer de bâtir l'économie en restant compétitif et en assurant le succès des travailleurs. Il y a une demande grandissante pour les véhicules électriques et le Canada a le potentiel d'être un chef de file en termes de fabrication de batteries pour ces véhicules, d'électrification et d'énergie propre. C'est en créant de bons emplois maintenant que nous continuerons à faire croître le secteur automobile pour l'avenir. Et parallèlement, le fait d'investir dans des technologies qui protègent l'environnement nous aidera à atteindre notre objectif de zéro émission de carbone net d'ici 2050. Le secteur automobile et l'environnement en sortent donc gagnants. tous les deux. Je tiens à remercier le premier ministre Ford pour son importante collaboration, ainsi que Jerry Diaz et le ministre Baines pour leur travail acharné. Voilà encore une preuve de plus qui démontre que, lorsqu'on travaille ensemble, on peut réaliser de grands progrès. Before I end, I want to thank the Bank of Montreal for asking their employees to download the COVID Alert app. And I hope that other companies will follow BMO's lead. As we approach Thanksgiving weekend, the COVID Alert app is just one of the many ways that we can keep each other safe. We also need to keep following public health guidelines. Wash your hands, wear a mask, keep a 2-meter distance from others, and download the COVID Alert app. À l'approche de la fin de semaine de l'Action de grâce, il faut continuer de suivre les recommandations de la santé publique. Lavez vos mains, portez un masque, gardez vos distances et téléchargez l'application Alerte COVID qui fait déjà une grande différence à travers le pays. We'll get through this together.